one local Olympian is celebrating Olympic glory. Glen Ellyn's Ethan Cepuran won a bronze medal in men's speed skating early this morning. It's the first Olympic medal for the 21-year-old Glenbard West graduate. It happened while most of Chicagoland was sleeping, but his family was up and watching. His dad, Carl, joins us now to talk about such an exciting day. Welcome.
Welcome. Good afternoon, good evening, whatever time it is, I don't know.
I'm sure your hours and your day is probably all mixed up, having been up so early to watch him compete. What time was that it was on?
It was just before 1 a.m. for okay. The first round, and then the second round was just before 3 a.m.
Ooh, man, so you guys pulled an all-nighter. What was it like seeing your son get to that level?
It's just incredibly unbelievable. I mean, I can't describe it really. It's beyond words, and that's unusual for me to be speechless. It's just more of a feeling and an emotion, and it's just unbelievable would have to be if I had to pick one word.
And you know, we've heard him being called the happy skater. Do you know where this nickname comes from?
Sure. Well, one of our good friends who managed the Park Ridge Speed Skating Club, where we used to co-op and go to practice with, we've been family friends for a long time. And then he's been involved in the sport for a long time, too. And when Ethan came along, he just said he's just different. Like, he's just happy to be out here, and he's always smiling, and, you know, he can fall. He's pretty inflammable. Nothing gets to him. So, and he's always got a smile on his face. He's just happy to be there. So that person kind of dubbed him with the nickname, and it kind of stuck. It kind of caught on.
So how did he talk to us about getting to this level? Was he always interested in skating? Was it something that just always interested? How did that come about?
Well, he mainly, like all youngest siblings, he wanted to do what his older brothers were doing. So and his brothers are 14 and 8 years older than him, so they were into some, you know, pretty advanced stuff already, and that didn't deter him at all. I mean, he wanted to jump right in, and so we would be going to skating practice in Glen Ellyn twice a week, and we would drop him off at the babysitter. This was when he was about 1.5 years old, and he'd only been walking for probably a couple of months at that point. And after a couple of weeks, he was intrigued by where we were going and leaving him at the same time. So he checked out our bags and he found skates, and he's like, all of a sudden throwing a tantrum when, and he doesn't usually throw a tantrum. So he really wanted to go. So we took him along and put him on the hockey bench, and that lasted about 2 weeks. And then we had another tantrum, and he wanted to be on the ice, so we put him on a 5-gallon bucket just to sit there, and that was good for about 2 weeks, too. And then he wanted skates like everybody else, and so it just kept progressing from there, and he was pushing around the bucket with skates that were, you know, way too big for him, but that's Ethan.
And what is it like for you to see your son be called a local hero, represent the country the way that he was, and even get to where he's at today?
It's very emotional, very fulfilling, kind of humbling, and really kind of unexpected. I mean, he's just doing what he loves to do, and in the way that he usually approaches things. I mean, he's very disciplined. He's very conscientious. He always puts in 100% at whatever he does, and he does what he enjoys, or he tries to make what he has to do very enjoyable. And he's also very social. He likes doing things with his friends and his teammates, and that's been huge for us. Like the from his brothers to his peers at the club, and then the competitors he's met over the years and other clubs and across the country. He's developed some really great friendships, and that's kind of kept him going, because the training is incredibly hard, and you need these other things to kind of benefits to kind of keep you going.
Mm-hmm. Now, I understand, you know, this is his first medal, but the Olympics isn't the end for him. He's not going to come back home right away. I understand the journey continues for him.
Yep, this year he was fortunate enough, along with both his teammates, Emery Lehman of Oak Park and Casey Dawson of Park City, to qualify for the World All-Around Championships. So you got to be in the top 24 in the world. And they're going to be in Hamar, Norway, where the 94 Olympics were, where Koss the Boss did his thing and made history. So it's a really cool place. It's a cool venue to skate. And it's also just very cool to get to skate in a world championships. So he's looking forward very much to doing that. And also, again, because the three of them qualified, they get to do it as a group. And they're looking forward, I think, to just competing with maybe, you know, without the Olympic spotlight and pressure on them, although they love pressure. But at the same time, you know, this is kind of a frosting on the cake opportunity.
That is amazing. Carl, is there anything else you'd like to add, you'd like people to know about your son or just the journey in general?
Good question. I just think, you know, find what you love, try different things, keep the big picture in mind, find other things to do. You know, you don't want sports to be your sole identity or define you. I think you want to be a well-rounded person, a good person first, and being a sportsman is certainly a big part of that and an opportunity to get to do that and be that way. But this is a gift, and he's, you know, worked really hard to develop it, but you can't pick or choose or craft it. You know, you kind of gotta, you know, see where they're moving and just support and encourage them and encourage them to try different things to find that gift.
Nice. Great advice, Carl. Thank you so much for joining us. And please do
send
congratulations along to your son from our behalf. And congratulations to you, too.
Thank you very much. We certainly will. And he's really felt the support from the community, both Glen Ellyn and Chicago area wide. So, you know, he sees the clips when he can. And he's remarked a couple of times already that it's been just beyond, you know, beyond his expectations as well.
Yeah, all of it very well deserved. Carl, thank you so much. Have a great one.
Thank you. You're welcome.